Hello. Welcome to my Thursday stream. Already, what, 2 minutes in? 3 minutes in? That's when I like to get started. How's everyone doing? Yeah, I know my screen looks kind of dark. But I'm playing with different cameras and different times of days and things like that. It's about as bright as I can get that ring light. But it's fine. I think it'll be okay. It's not going to affect the gaming too much, I don't think. But I'm switching around different cameras. You know what? I could probably get a little more light out of it this way. There you go. Yeah. That didn't do as much as I wanted it to do. There we go. Interesting. Okay. All right. Yeah, I'll play with that a little more later. Hold on. I wonder if I can do this live without messing anything up too much. Anyway, hope everyone is having a lovely Thursday. We're going to have a regular stream like we always do today. We're going to stream on Twitch and YouTube at the same time. Technology. We are going to drink some Diet Coke. Nature's finest brown fluid. And, I'm going to fly around in some kind of airplane. We're going to talk about planes. And then the second half of the stream is going to be me playing Ken's Lounge Act. Not the not electric piano, not fake book stuff. Just me playing the regular lounge tunes. Time to practice that stuff up again. You know, been a while. So let's just get to the actions there. All right. This is my world map. Of course, a little too early for anyone to suggest any locations. It's also kind of hard to tell what the weather is in advance. Well, where haven't we been to in a while? What is this area? Naples. There's like a Mount Vesuvius. You know what I mean? Okay, we flew the Spirit B-2 or whatever it is bomber last time, which is not a vintage airplane. And I like to fly the vintage airplanes. Although I also like to fly any of the smaller airplanes, which we don't fly this one very much, the turboporter. We don't fly these a lot. We don't fly the 172 that much, but that's kind of a modern plane. Well, how about something that won't be too horrible and might be fun to fly, but could probably get us the altitude if we need it, like this one here. It comes in some fun liveries. White AVG with a shark nose. I mean, come on. I think we always use that one, but still. Ramp. So yeah, today's stream is going to be a lot like every other stream. We shall be flying for 45 minutes or so, one or two missions. Missions meaning take off, fly around, land. We shall be taking a short break, and then we're going to play a... keyboard session, I would say. Gosh, I'm wondering if I can really adjust this. Can't adjust. This thing doesn't really adjust it. Yeah, I see what it's doing there. It's doing auto balance. What if I can turn that off? Properties. Configure video. Brightness is not auto. White balance it is. But exposure is set to auto. And that just, that's just my airplane. So now when I adjust the manual aperture, does it change anything? Yeah, all right, good. Now I can actually adjust it to where I like it from there. It's a manual lens. I want to be able to adjust it manually. Okay. We're making some progress here. too big though. Should be like that. All right, first thing we're gonna do here, hold on a couple of seconds, sorry for random delays. Change it to daytime so we can see what we're doing. Usual, we'll go for kind of a late afternoon-ish flight. Looks like a beautiful day to fly around Naples. This is our aeroplano of the day. I mean, I don't know what, it's got a little garish. But I mean, come on, look, that's awesome. Why are our flaps are down? Why are our flaps down? Put our flaps up. They're not doing anything. That's because our plane's off. We'll get it. We'll get started up. Okay. At least they fixed some bugs here. Okay. Fuel to. I guess we have to start on left. Master battery, alternators, avionics master, fuel switch pump. It starts right up, I believe, at this point. Oh, wait a minute. Sorry. Wrong. Propeller. Mixture to full. Throttle to around there. Sorry. Now it's starting up. It's uncut. Start drying up. First time every time. You know what I mean? All right. Let's. What do we got here? Looking at that. We want to hit enter. Make this go into map mode. It's autopilot. These are lighting controls over here. Right? Circuit breakers, flaps. What are these? They don't even say. Oh, we can move the vent around that. That's great. What are these? ELT testing buttons. Oh, is it, what's this? Shouldn't battery master? Oh, that's the backup battery. Sorry. Backup battery. You can leave it off for now, I believe. Interesting. What's in the glove box? Pick up the brochure. Oh, that is cool. I did not know it had a brochure. That's wild. The brochure comes with the airplane when you buy it. Well, in the glove box. Well, come on, people. That's content for you right there. All right. Which way are we heading? Probably south.
Ground KNSH 9999 with Alpha request taxi for takeoff south departure.
I got you. It always sets it some random volume each time I gotta reset. Like it would remember the volume. Nope, each time. Every single day I play. Every single day. Alright.
Taxiing hold short runway 2.
And taxiway Charlie Kench 9999. How's everybody on my YouTubes? All right, let's get the heck out of here. Oh, I like how that front thing moves like that. Ooh, yeah, all shiny and new. All right, well, we got a ways to go to get to the end of the terminal. That's for sure. So let's head out there. All right, now we can put our flaps up because we have our electrical system going. I believe they're electrically activated. So now they're at zero. I like this plane has those manual features. It's got the propeller pitch and mixture control. Where are we heading out to? Yeah, we'll take a shortcut out this way. We're flying out of Naples, Italy today. We probably shouldn't be on the runway, but it'll let us. We don't really need to go all the way down. I'm just going to go a ways down, turn around, and take off. I'm going to head towards Nibli. By the way, that there is Mount Vesuvius. Somewhat impressive structure in the background. We're heading there. After we check out Naples. That's what it looks like from here. Oh, what's up here? I brought some switches. Okay, nav lights, yes. Strobe lights, we need. Nav lights, no. Taxi lights, not, no. It's not in the daytime. Pulse mode. These are various panel lights. Oops. Yeah, no worries. Probably don't need the panel lights. Okay, yeah, everything looks good. I'm not seeing any specific warnings on the screen. Garments seem happy. Alright, we're reaching the end of the runway that we care about. So we're going to start wailing on the brakes here. And we get right from here. Okay. We are ready to go.
Tower KENSH 9999 ready for south.
Flaps to 1/3.
Catch 9999 wind calm south departure.
So we're going to leave this runway and then kind of head a little to the south, but it's basically southwest.
Cleared for takeoff runway 24 KENSH 9999.
Okay. Throttle to full. Where you're going. All right, so this is the airport at Naples. Should you fly into Naples, you'll probably land here. And you'll notice, look at that big mountain on the volcano on the left side there. You're not supposed to fly over the airport. Let's go. Anyway,
Tower KENSH 9999.
All right, start backing off
departure.
On the engine. We can start going into a nicer regime on the throttle. Hold on here. Oops. Mixture. Propeller. Throttle. All right, and this is the city of Naples, Italy. It's another one of our European city tour that we kind of pick at random at the last possible second. That we're gonna do a little, we'll do a little canyon carving on. I'm always impressed when we fly in the city center how some of the modern architecture is in these European cities. But I like to just look at the layout again. This is, you can tell that is commuter rail mainly. I guess there's probably some freight. But these all look like kind of main. I guess maybe these could be freight rail as well. Top Gun Carrier, Naples. You'd have to tell me what the heck they're referring to. That does not look like a carrier or anything Top Gun related. Maybe it is though. Okay. Ooh, I like the docks. They're very nicely modeled. With all those light. Those are the towers. We've got actual cargo ships and not pictures of cargo ships. That's nice. I like it. Blah, do. Okay. Wait, why are my flaps still down? Where are we going to do? Okay, yeah, right in here. Oh, there's some stuff we want to check out up there. But this looks like kind of a new area. But then we'll go check out the old city. Right in here. We're going to attempt to do a little canyon carving right here. Looks like all these buildings are a little cookie cutter. But what is this bad boy right here? Right here. First of all, it's still under construction because that's a crane. Kind of hard to tell. But I don't know what they're building there. But that looks like some kind of architectural. Now you can see this is a very kind of dense, modern area. So you know what we're going to do, like we always do right around here, we don't need this by the way, is we are going to go to Google Maps. Like, I know everything about Naples, Italy. I've never been there. But Maps, Google often knows more. Now, it won't give us the ability to click through and get more information. Naples, Italy. Thank you. Oh, what are these doing? These are lovely models, though, of buildings. Sexy. What is this? Okay, Naples there. And then, okay. All right, where's the water? Okay, the water is back there. There's the thingy. Oof, I don't know where we are yet. We'll have to figure that out. All right, we'll figure it out. Hold on. I got the map up, but I don't exactly know where we are. Yeah, there's the main kind of freeway, and then it turns right. So. Maybe it's here. Some sense. No. That's exactly it. I don't know exactly where I am yet. This intersection look like kind of complicated. That's a toll road there. All right, let's head back towards the new area, which is down this road, or sorry, the old area. That's the new area there. Just kind of watching how the things are kind of already. You can tell. Kind of from the hub and spoke system, like something is important if a bunch of streets sort of converge on it. So let's see what this is. Whoa. It's not really a hub and spoke system. This is a really complicated, but I believe this is a museum. Archaeological Museum, right here, the National Archaeological Museum of Naples. It does appear to have the correct style, sort of, maybe not, I don't want to say that for sure. It's a big city. I'm going to have to orient it myself, though. Yeah, no, I think it's further up. What does that say up there? Okay, nope, see, this is the building. I was thinking of. Okay, well, at least now I know kind of where I am. Because we look at the landmarks. Pretty from up here, I think. This is the National Archaeological Museum of Naples, right here. Not that one right there. Okay. So then we're going to head out to the water. And again, a great number of domed buildings, unique, interestingly shaped dome buildings of various designs. Real interesting stuff. I don't think we can go canyon carving down there. That'd be instant death. And the Castel Nuovo, the new castle. Let's check this out. Let's see if Google has anything to say about this bad boy. Alrighty. Naples, Italy, by the way. If you were to go there, it might look like this. Look at that ship, got something on it. All right, where are we? Okay, let's go here. It is. Where's the new castle? where exactly are we here? There's a curve there. Oh, yeah, no, this way. Okay. This is the... What does it say about it? Quick, tell me something. Castle Nuovo. Tell me something about it, please, Google. If it wants to. The keep was the tallest tower inside a medieval castle. The Angevin Dynasty. This one here. As usual. Good visit. €6. Very reasonable. Such a large place, not much is open. Says you can only tell about the. Naples is underrated, vibrant, passionate city with so much culture and charm. I stay by the castle and love being by the sea. Lots of delicious food and friendly people. Look, you're getting some color here, okay? That's what's called color. And what else is down here? This is an ornate 18th century theater. Right there. All right, let's keep going. Right here. Not that, but I think back there all the way. Oh, and then this puppy here is the Plaza de something. Wow. Okay. And then up here, let's check it out. It looks like St. Elmo's Castle is up here. This is a wild terrain, though, boy. When they build these ancient cities on hills like this, it's always like, wow, impressive. Pretty model there, St. Elmo's Castle. Let me see if I can say anything about this on the Google Maps. This is the Orologio Castello, ancient castle de St. Elmo, blah, blah, blah. Good place, great views of the city, sublime views of the city, and the castle itself is out of fairy tales. Good place to get great views, blah, blah, blah. Medieval fortress located on the Palmieri Hill, adjacent to the Certosa di San Martino, overlooking Naples, Italy. The name, blah, blah, blah. Okay, you think you can click on it, but you can't. It just says dot, dot, dot. Look it up yourself. This is Google. We don't care if you can find the information or not. All right. It is time to travel further than we've traveled, and actually attempt to scale that hill over there, for which we're going to need a little more power and a little patience. We'll take one last kind of pass over the city at relatively high speed, and then we're going to try to get up to the top of this little hill up there, Mount Vesuvius. We have plenty of fuel. And we have time. We got another... I like to go about 45 minutes on these missions. I keep under... Well, I do not understand what Top Gun Carrier means, though, that's for sure. So there's the Cathedral of the Assumption of Mary. But I bet you can already see there's probably a dozen cathedrals just in view there. At least... These cities just went nuts on the cathedrals. They built like dozens and dozens of them. Then it's cool. Then there's this kind of modern, like very planned out new city there. Lots of rail access. Also very distinctive. This city doesn't appear to be built on a major river. I'm sure there is a river around there somewhere. But obviously, you know, it's oceanside. But not river. But we're going up to that little hill up there. See what it looks like from up there. It could be fun. I mean, I don't know why it would be, but... Alright, what are we set at here? What are our controls? No, you don't want to give me controls. Also, uh-oh. There we go. Slight propeller. That's good. Okay, we're fine. It was just loading some stuff. Okay, you see, they like their toll roads down there. You can always see a road that's a toll road. You see the toll booth. And I wonder, I think Naples weather is nice, but it's not like, you know, there's like city beaches probably. You probably have to drive way down. So, oh, finally. I approve. Or whatever you're tasking me for. I wonder how high up Vesuvius is. It's obviously not that tall. It's just real close to where people are living. But it is still, I think, considered active. But I do like to do volcano flights. Because, we're only at like 2,600 feet. And we're probably only get to about 5,000 feet, I think. Still, it's always impressive when there's just a mountain that just kind of sits by itself. Just, and in this case, highly developed terrain. Like, there looks like there's people living in around the entire circumference due to the, association with Naples being an urban center and major Italian city. I also think we've always got some mapping issues there, where it changes mapping type from actual city to there, where it's really flat. It's just that's just satellite imagery mapped onto terrain, as opposed to the actual buildings. The fun thing to do is come up in a helicopter and try to land in the caldera. I mean, that's a story to tell somebody. You survive it. It looks like you can see down there. There's a way up because there's switchback trails there. I don't know if you can get it by car. Well, there's people up here, so yeah. Obviously, you can drive up here. And you can drive up here, the back part here. Yeah, it looks like there's a nice... Oh, you can see it. You can drive all the way up. Because you can see there's a cut on the side of the volcano. We'll follow it up. So you drive up here. There's the road. Come up around here. Right? There's a couple people living there. I don't know if I'd want to live there. Probably cold. Then there's these switchbacks. There's somebody living here. And then it switchbacks all the way up. You know, it's probably more like a, I don't know, visitor center kind of thing. Try not to actually smash into the volcano. We circle for height. What are we at? 4,300? That's not very high up for a volcano. You know, Mauna Loa is like 13,000 feet up. Mauna Kea. Kilauea is not that high up. That is a nice looking caldera, though. Look at that. Beauty. Flying over Vesuvius. That's what it's going to look like from up here. Now, you're going to get a view. That's one of the things. You're going to get a view, your 360-degree Italy view there. But you're not really going to get anywhere else. And it is a pretty day in Naples. That's it, Naples. That's the main city of Naples back there. But you can see the urban sprawl, effectively. Goes practically as far as you can see towards those mountains there. All right, let's get this cut this engine down and start heading downhill. I wonder if we can find a aeropuerto that would take us. It's not the one we started from. You see on our terrain map there. Okay, we took off from Lerne. I don't think there are any airports that are closer. And we do not want to smash. So we'll just go back there. Right? No other airports around here. No little ones? No. Alright, we'll just land back in Naples. Not very far. It's actually quite close. It's not like we had to go far a long way to go to Vesuvius and see the city. It's like a 5-minute trip. All right. Trying to tune my airspace there. I guess we'll solve my import. Fun.
Tower KNSH 9,
by the way, cheers, old Daiko.
7 miles southeast, 3,100 feet with Alpha to land.
Got it. Good. What was the altimeter 2994? We got to just. We have an altimeter adjustment around here somewhere. It's fine. I like this, that this plane flies with a stick instead of. Oh yeah, we needed to check our fuel. We should switch to right. We're fine though. All right, so we're gonna be coming down. So for this operation, we are going to adjust the mixture a little bit if we can. Mixture. What's in here? Nothing. Okay. That's sad deluxe. And that is the runway that we're going to some altitude. And then we're gonna land. And then we're gonna take off. No, we're gonna switch. I think we'll switch to music. It's getting that time. I gotta figure out how to get how to adjust the this camera though. A little better. I think the other thing is I'm gonna switch back, switch to various different cameras. Because I have this, I have three cameras and I'm deciding whether this one's better than the other one. Get a little brighter though, right? Like that. Or is it then automatically adjusted down again? That should be better. I'm trying to do it by visuals. That's a lot better. Actually, this—it's funny. This lens has three adjustments on it: aperture, manual, rings, telephoto, and focus. You got to do them manually. There's nothing automatic on it, which I like. But it is kind of noisy unless you get the picture's kind of noisy unless you get it adjusted just right. Oops. Okay, left. Make a sharp lefty. Make a lefty loosey. Righty tighty. Fine. We're fine. So it looks like a mirror. A little high up. We're fine. All right. Bring the engine down. Flaps 2/3. Throttle down to pretty much nothing. Flaps all the way. There we are coming down. Rear trailing flaps. Check our lights, they look good. Our ILS lights look fine. Give us a little juice, we do not want to stall out. We're at what? 73, and we'd like to land right around 55. To avoid any kind of bouncing activity. When I hear a small plane flying around me outside, it's like, oh, that could be me. I'm sitting in my chair. Flying around. What's our speed? 77. Engine down, flare out. Ooh, a little hard and a little fast. Ooh. Not even good. Ow. That was not good at all. That was a zero. Was it too? It just wasn't the right. This wasn't the right. I don't know. Didn't have quite the correct attitude. Speed was close. Speed was close.
Going to 121.9er, KNSH 9999er.
And we're back where we started. Which is fine. We had a nice little flight. I enjoyed Naples. It was definitely different. I haven't seen it before. We got a chance to see the volcano. Looked around the cities, checked out the cathedrals, went to the modern section, the old section, the waterfront area. It was cool. I would do that again someday, but there's plenty of other cities in Europe that I haven't checked out. Hundreds. I specifically mean ones that are, well, interestingly, modeled in Microsoft Flight Simulator. Does this plane have a door that opens? Oh yeah, it does, actually. But we can't do it right now. Okay. Actually, ground. Can we go to parking?
Ground KNSH 9999er, request taxi to parking.
Oh, I ain't doing any of that. I'll just park here. Why can't I just park here? Look at all these other planes parked here. You know what I mean? Screw you. Get out of the way, I'm parking here. Look, it's an empty spot. I'm mowing you down and I'm parking here.
Did you hear my last transmission?
Yeah, but I didn't hear.
Taxiing to General Aviation Parking via taxiway Charlie Bravo cross runway 06 Bravo Alpha Kench 9999.
Heck yes. Now, can we open the door on the other side? Open the door. Oh yeah. Door's open. Oh, by the way, and they're these fantastic gullwing doors. Which, you know what I mean? Sexy. Oh, and those things in the back, those are steps. Those are not like, those are just to put your foot on the bottom back behind the thing. Those are so you can get out easier, I think. I don't think those are aerodynamic or anything. I think. I don't know. All right. How do we shut her down? We shut her down basically by cutting the mixture to zero. And setting our fuel to off. Turning off. Oops. Everything else. And changing this to off. Beautiful. And then for some reason, it's a Microsoft bug. That if you turn off your plane with the doors open, it closes them. It's just a flight simulator. It's a quirk. I would say. Yeah, they had a good time together, I think, today. They enjoyed their flight over Naples. And so did I. And that, you know, having that shark front painted on this plane, there's Vesuvius in the back. I'm going to take a screenshot, excuse me. Yeah, this will do it. Okay. I know there's other ways to do it, but this way I get to do a little cropping. Just a nice day. Maybe I should have that guy in the shot. The city's down that way. We were up there. That's the hill where that thing, that castle is. Okay. Cool. I feel like I know the place. All right. Well, you know what that means. That means that it's time, pretty much halfway through this stream, every single time, we switch to music, and that means it's going to take me about 5 minutes. I'm going to bring my piano right here and plug it right in, and then we're going to play piano for about 45 minutes. It'll be fun. See you guys then. Stick around. Hello, we're back. How's everyone doing? Thank you for coming to my little stream here. A lot of people watch on YouTube, delayed. I can't even tell if that's I think I messed up the focus. Hold on one second here. That. I'll quickly readjust the focus here. That's another problem with this is very sensitive to focus changes. Especially when it's like that. I think we'll be fine. I'm gonna mess with this camera some more, but if I can't get it right, I might go back to a regular old webcam. Today, we're just gonna be playing our regular Ken's Lounge, I call it. This list of songs that I have memorized. I don't have to look at the notes usually too much, and at least I don't want to have to. So that's why I practice them at least once a week. Where's my pedal? Here's my pedal. Let's see if it works. Gonna eat a lot of peaches. Moving to the country. Gonna eat a lot of peaches. Moving to the country. Gonna eat me a lot of peaches. Moving to the country. Gonna eat a lot of peaches. Peaches come from a can. They were put there by a man in a factory downtown. If I had my little way, I'd eat peaches every day. Sun soaking bulges in the shade. Moving to the country, gonna eat a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, gonna eat me a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, gonna eat a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, gonna eat me a lot of peaches. I took a nap with the roots all twist. I squished a rotten peach in my fist. And I dreamed about you, woman. I poked my finger down inside to make a little room for an ant to hide. Well, nature's candy in my hand, or can, or pie. Millions of peaches, peaches for me. Millions of peaches, peaches for free. Millions of peaches, peaches for me. Millions of peaches, peaches for free. Peaches. It's not really a lounge song, but you know, this is more of a lounge song. Here. I forgot how this song starts. I need to get the starter for it. Just a quick starter for it. Otherwise, I won't remember how to play it. But did I just hear the covers? Couple.
My daughter now.
Hold on, yeah. Do. Just get the auto. How does it start? Right. That's all you need to remember. That's this one. Okay. See, now it's way too bright. It kind of switched on me at some point. Right? That's not good. I'm trying to just match these two cameras so they're kind of the same. I turned off the auto brightness and I think it's still messing with it. It's got a manual iris. Thursday going. Welcome to the lounge. I wonder if I just be messing with this all day. A cheers, a little Diet Coke for everyone. Why not? Okay, I'm going to keep playing the canon, as we call it, the classic songs that I like to play. Okay, let's do this one in time, right?
One, two, five.
This is effectively a metronome that ensures that I do everything. See, now I'm looking really nasty in red. I'd rather be pasty in white. That's better. I'm never going to get this right tonight. Not today. Also, yeah, no, it keeps compensating. I set it to manual and it keeps compensating. Why can't you just be manual? Let me take a peek here. Manual, configure video. Is everything still manual? Oh, no, it's still manual. Should be manual. I don't know what it's doing. Okay. Oh, I better pause that camera. All right, I think we're fine though. We're back, right? We're back. Yeah, we're back. Okay, more songs. Yee! Hmm. Okay, he's gonna work on that. All right, ready. Let's see if we can do this. Fun to do on the little band in a box feature. It's a Warren Zevon song that I'm gonna sing here. It's called Johnny Strikes Up the Band. Excuse me. Dry your eyes, my little friends. Let me take you by the hand. Freddy getting ready, rock steady, when Johnny strikes up the band. We'll be rocking in the projects, walking down along the strand. Freddy getting ready, rock steady, when Johnny strikes up the band. When Johnny strikes up the band. Johnny strikes up the wind, Johnny strikes up the wind, Johnny strikes up the band. And Johnny is my main man. Hi, Science is the keeper of the keys. He'll put your mind at ease. He's guaranteed to please, back by popular demand. Look around, my little friends. Jubilation fills the land. Warren Zevon song from Excitable Boy. Actually, it's the opening song from Excitable Boy, the album by Warren Zevon. The amazing album, classic album. How's everyone doing today? Science, good to see you. I already did the flight simulator segment. We flew over Naples. It was quite fun. Still get my camera, not to make me look like I'm about to die. It's a new camera I'm still working on. It's funny, man. It's supposed to be completely manual, and I'm having trouble getting it to manually change anything, any of the settings. My manual, I should be able to adjust it by these three rings on the lens. These physical rings. That's why I specifically got this camera. It's got no controls on it. It's got a lens with a focus ring, zoom ring, and an aperture ring. But it fights the aperture ring. In other words, if you open it up, it darkens you, and if it closes it up, it lightens you up. What's the, that, you know, that's not how it works. I want it to be dark or light under my control. So I can open up the aperture a little bit more, and it's not going to do anything. Didn't do anything except reduce the focus. Didn't do anything. Anyway, I'll work on it later. Maybe I can get it to manually operate later. Or I'll just switch it back to the next Go camera and send this one back. I don't know. I haven't decided. There's things I like about this camera. It's actually a very sharp image. There's noise, but it's extremely sharp in the face in this part. I don't know if I like that, but it is what it is. You know what I mean? All right, what are we going to do here? Another song or two or three or four? Trust nobody, trusting even less their wives. Until I found somebody, there was no one I preferred. My heart was made of stone, my eyes saw only misty gray. Until you came into my life, girl, I saw everything this way. I think I would have been a sad man all my life. I think I see the light coming through me, coming through me, giving me a second sight. Song called Shine, but I'm doing an instrumental song here. I'm not gonna sing this one, I couldn't even try. Thank you. just a classic lounge kind of song, I think, really. Along with Misty. Just my camera a little bit here. Up a bit. Yeah, that'll be better. Yeah. Lighting is so fucked up on this camera. It goes back and forth. It's like cycling. That's the worst thing I've ever seen in my life. It was really dark a few seconds ago, like a minute ago. Now it's super bright. Everything's washed out. You can't see cheese. I keep adjusting this aperture and adjust this aperture. Okay. So that's perfect. But then it seems to kind of like override it. And it's a physical setting on the camera. It's got to be. And I turned all the auto adjustments off. And this aperture is a physical iris. It's a physically opening and closing the iris on the camera. There's no reason why it should change unless something is changing, massively changing about the lighting in the house. And I don't think it is. The way I'm doing is I'm looking at the sign. Because if the sign is too bright, you won't see the eyes in the sign. Believe it or not, that's how I'm telling if it's blown out. I don't mind if I look a little dark, but I don't want the eyes blown out of the sign. I'll figure it out, but I'm just going to be yelling and raging and playing with it until then. Yeah, that's too dark. Hold on. Okay, let's try there. Okay, help. Still see eyes. All right, we're good. They're not great, but we're good. I think it must be. I'm going to check it later, see if it's auto-adjusting, because it seems to be changing. And again, nothing's moving on the lens. It's a lens with a three-barrel lens. It's small, but it's a very effective three-barrel lens. Aperture, that's the iris, focus, and it's got a two-level, 2x optical zoom. Which is nice, because I'm able to completely frame it just like I like it using the zoom, the physical zoom in it. At least that's not changing. And the focus isn't changing, but the brightness seems to be. It could be my imagination. I don't know, I'll figure it out. I actually think it's fine now. I just don't touch it. I'm wondering, it might be very sensitive to the changes in the, whether it's cloudy out, which will be tomorrow, I think. We'll figure it out. By the way, I hope you're enjoying today's installment of Ken's Lounge. How are you doing, Donnie? Good to see you here. I just want to say welcome, everybody, to Ken's Lounge. We'll play a little bit more today, just the regular old lounge songs. And as always, I like to say, if you're enjoying yourself in the lounge today, I only ask one thing. And that is you sidle up to the bar. You order yourself a fancy cocktail. Not a not a cheap, you know, beer or well drink or something like that. Not for you, not for me, okay? And that, most importantly, that you tip very generously to the wait staff, because they have on average at least 6 kids. That's a lot of mouths to feed. So, cheers, Diet Coke for me. That's all I really need.
Thank you.
routine. No, we can't dance together. It's dark yet. No, we can't talk at all. Please take me along when you slide on down. I figure what's going on. See, it's dark again. Dark. It darkened itself. Maybe it'll lighten itself later when it feels like it. Might have something to do with the background. I think it's background. I think it's compensating for the background in the reverse direction that it's supposed to. Ugh. And if I can't turn background compensation off, that's definitely when going back to the store. I just want it to be manual. I want to control everything manually. I don't want anything to change unless I change it. It's hard to find a camera that will do that. Unless it's super expensive. The super expensive you can put in manual mode. This is not a super expensive. It's a surveillance camera. It's super simple. It's just a box with a sensor in the back and a lens. It shouldn't have any electronics in it. Cheers. A little Diet Coke for one. I swirled it all over the place. Not all the place. Still a little bit left. As you know, when we run out of Diet Coke, yeah, that's pretty much the end of the show. And I really only allow myself to drink one Diet Coke per day because I'm not addicted, all right? Come on. It's one a day. There's a man who leads a life of danger. Everyone he meets, he stays a stranger. Going with every move he makes, no another chance he takes. Odds on he won't live to see tomorrow. Two is too much, you gotta cut down. Beware of pretty faces you may find. A pretty face can hide an evil mind. Oh, be careful what you say. Don't give yourself away. Odds are you won't live to see tomorrow. Well, secret agent man, secret agent man. Well, they give you a number and they've taken away your name. Sunning in the Riviera one day, then bleeding in a Bombay alley next day. Oh, don't let the wrong word slip when kissing persuasive lips. Oh, odds on you won't live to see tomorrow. Well, secret agent man, secret agent man, where they give you a number and they take it away your name. Well, look out, agent man, secret agent man, this mysterious life you choose is a deadly game. Do 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 do. Carpenters. We are getting kind of the end of the show when I must return, sadly, to my work obligations. Sadly, although I like my work obligations. It's nothing too stressful, I'm sure. At least I don't have to go to a lot of meetings every day. Just a couple a week. And it's a good paycheck, trust me. Well, a couple more songs. What you do here? Yeah, I always like playing this. No, it's an E, isn't it? Yeah. Picking up the pieces of my dream shattered dream. Thank you. Science, was it a laptop computer or a desktop computer you got through work? Usually, I've never heard of anybody really getting a desktop computer through work. They always get laptops. I have a laptop. I hate it. It's a, that they work gave me. It's a HP ZBook, I believe. ZBook. They call it the ZBook because Z is the end of the alphabet and you can't get any farther away from good. See what I'm saying? It's a laptop. Yeah, I hope it's not a fucking ZBook. It tends to run at about 400 degrees at all times, even when set, even when doing nothing. And the fans are zzzz, right too hot. Well, you're not doing anything. You're literally close, not doing anything. Don't get a ZBook. And what? Ah, oh, that's my ad for. Boy, they're going to come after me now. Okay, what else are we going to play? We're going to play a couple more songs. What do we got here? Yeah, the Elite books are better than the Z book. You got lucky. The Z books are, they'll have like I, and they have fan, they have much higher desktop kind of like 90 watt processors in them. The Elite books actually are have the regular i5s and i3s in it. Bet you have an i5. I wish I had an i5. Stream for me, boy. I wish I could play longer, but I'm at the 140 mark and I really got to get my piano back over there. But good news, tomorrow will be a nice long Friday stream and I should have this this awful picture quality fixed, but I don't know for sure. In any case, if I can't fix this camera, I'll go back to my other camera. So it will be fixed by tomorrow. I'm going to work on it later. And this is only the second day I'm using this camera, so I'm still experimenting with the features. I only got it like 2 days ago. Let's see, 3 days ago. Tomorrow should be another stream. It'll be a guitar-oriented stream because I like to alternate, so we'll do guitar tomorrow. But Flight Simulator, of course. Hope you enjoy the Flight Simulator and the guitar and all that stuff. Of course you do. You would be here. People keep commenting on like YouTube. They're like, wow, you like music and Flight Simulator. Thanks, Wilma. Hey, Wilma. Hold on a second. Wilma, you don't come here that often. You haven't been here the first time chat. We talk in Milo May's stream all the time. Occasionally, I'll be there. You know, she's not streaming today, but I appreciate you coming by, of course. And I, you know, watch on VODs. I stream every day, so if you come by a little earlier, you can actually catch the whole stream. But I haven't really talked about my stream on May on May's stream. Because you know, I don't want to promote myself, and so I don't even think she knows that I stream, but I've been doing it since August on a daily basis, so I know you've been following me, and I appreciate that. I follow you too. So but it come by anytime if you want. We do music every other day, live music. It's a live show. It's fun. So I do have to go back to work, but I'll see you guys next time.